Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome to App Store Domination. And in today's video, we are going to talk about screenshots. So let's get to work. Okay, before we dive into screenshots, let me just remind you that the continuation of App Store Domination is the tribe. So go ahead and take a look at the tribe on our channel and maybe reach out for our support team. Hit this contact us and send us a message if you are an indie developer, because we do have some very special discounts for indie devs and studios. So that put aside, let's get into screenshots. Okay, now we are inside our iTunes Connect dashboard inside ASD Magic. And if you don't know how we got here, go ahead and take a look at the previous videos. Okay, and now we want to add some screenshots to our submission. So go ahead and click on Prepare for Submission, and you will be presented with this screen. And here we have three types of screenshots and previews. Of course, we are not going to talk about previews at this time. They are inside the tribe. Basically, previews are videos. Okay, screenshots are just simple static images. Okay, as you can see, iPhone 5.8 display is optional. So we will not talk about, we will not add them at this time. Instead, you need to add iPhone 5.5 and iPad 12.9 displays for your screenshots. And when you first go into your prepare for submission, you will not have, of course, any screenshots. So let's take a look at the dimensions you need to provide. So tap on iOS screenshot properties and you will be taken to this page. And as you can see, there are here are the device sizes or the platform and screenshot size. This is what we need and if it is required or not. Now, what is this? Well, as of I believe 1 year ago, Apple introduced these basic reusable screenshots. What that means is that you can add one screenshot for your iPhone version and one screenshot for your iPad version, and the App Store, where the iTunes Connect, automatically resizes it for all screen sizes. Of course, this doesn't include the newest iPhone 10 screenshot because it has different dimensions. That is why at this time it is optional. Okay, I believe it will be required sometime in the near future. Now, what we need is the largest the largest screenshot. So we need the largest display, and that is the 5.5 inch Retina display. As it you can see, it is required if app runs on iPhone, and because all of our source codes, and I believe you too want that too, all of your source codes are on iPad and iPhone, so they are universal. You will need an iPad screenshot too, required if app runs on iPad. And you can see, may use this 4.7 inch display, may use the 5.5 inches display. And that is what I was talking about when they are downsizing the screenshot from the 5.5 inch Retina display image. Okay, and that is it. You need to create a let's say we are in portrait mode. If you have landscape, then you use these dimensions. So let's create this portrait. Okay, and I will just launch Adobe Photoshop here, and we will create two screenshots, and one is for the iPad and one is for the iPhone. We will start off with the iPhone. So let me just copy out what we need here. So 1242 by, and let me just paste that in here. So the width will be 1242. And don't even bother trying to memorize these pixels. You just go into this page and copy that out. Okay, and resolution 72 will be just fine. So let's create this. Okay, and here we have our basic iPhone 5.5 inch display. And let me just go and find my logo here. I would just simply drag and drop it, maybe make it a little smaller, much larger logo here, and this will be my screenshot. Now you will not you will not add your logo here, you will add the screenshot of your app, and let me just show you how you can do that. First of all, you just simply launch your app on the simulator, and let's just select iPhone 8 Plus for our simulator now, because that is the largest screen size. Okay, let's just wait for it to load. Well, I believe it will be a simple red background, but anyway, we will just wait for it to load and show you how you can make that screenshot. So here is your brand new app that you want to add to the App Store. Well, it most probably will be much more interesting than this red background. Now, what you need to do is go into the simulator, and under File, you see New Screenshot, or hit Command S, but in some Macs, Command S brings up Siri, so I will not use this shortcut. So hit New Screenshot, and this screenshot will be saved onto your desktop. So let's find that. And here it is, simulator screenshot, iPhone 8 Plus, and the date and today's date. So what you need to do is now, because this dimension is 1020 by 1830. So this is not the dimension that Apple requires. So what you need to do now is go into your Photoshop file and simply drag and drop it. Okay, and here we are. And now I will just simply free transform, scale it to size. And that is it. That is how you can add your, and go ahead and create new screenshots for your app. Okay, five, there you can have five, up to five screenshots. So for now, I will just delete this. I don't need that. And I will just simply save as, and let me just go into here. Yeah, it will be screenshot, maybe iPhone, and that should be fine. And I will just save it as PNG, but make sure you don't have any alpha values on your PNG files. iTunes Connect will not accept images with alpha values. Okay, now let's create our iPad version. So the iPad version is, here it is, 2048 by 2732. Okay, let's create this one right now. Let's go into new. Okay, and I will just drag and drop my icon here. As usual, you need to create this screenshot with the simulator, with the help of the simulator, and just scale it to size. Okay, now let us just save as, and I will just save this as screenshot. Let it be of PNG, and let's save it. Okay, I believe I saved it into day 8, which is not the where I want to save it, so I will just move it. Where are they? Here they are, screenshots, iPad and iPhone. Okay, now finally we go back to iTunes Connect and select iPhone 5.5 inch display, and just simply drag and drop your screenshot here, and it will try to add it, and it sees that this is your preview, well, your screenshot that is 5.5, and it can be used to create the other screenshots. This is what it basically says here. Okay, and now we will click OK. And that is it. You have one screenshot for your iPhone. Of course, you can add up to 5 screenshots. Now let's go to iPad and do the same thing. Okay, screenshot iPad. Let's wait for it. Click on OK. And that's it. Yeah, finally, we need to click on save to save the changes. And that is it. You can, of course, add iPhone 5.8-inch displays, screenshot, but it goes the same way. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. And as usual, go ahead and do this for yourself, do this for your app. Do these 2 screenshots, at least 2 screenshots, because Apple requires at least 1 screenshot per device. So go ahead and create your screenshots, and I will see you in the next one. Good stuff. Now, if you want to see more of this video and want to boost your app business, go ahead and take a look at my 30 days challenge, App Store Domination. Go ahead and click the link down below, and I will see you inside ASD, App Store Domination. Let's get to work.